show that will encourage, give hope, and speak life to inspire and motivate those who want to refresh their passion for life and live it to the fullest. Feel free to tune in and listen to the inspired words from life speakers Sharon Dotson and Wayne I. Dotson, who speaks life the way God gives to them, and the guests that will assist and help bringing hope, motivation, and encouragement to you along life's journey to understand that everything will work out for your good to help you survive and thrive the tests of life that may come your way to walk in destiny and purpose.
Life Speakers Radio Show with Sharon Dotson and
Wayne I. Dotson.
We are coming to you because we are so excited to be with you today. We are here to give you a pick-me-up and to give you a hope like never before, because God said it and we believe it, and that settles it. Wayne, how you doing today?
Yes, ma'am. Mom, what's going on? How are you? I'm well. I'm straight. What about you? How you is?
I am doing well. I'm ready to speak some life today. What about you?
Oh, yes, ma'am. We on it. Let's do it. Let's have some fun and speak some life to the world out there.
Yes. So, in your world, we are so excited to be here today with you. Not only that, but we have a special guest who is in the house. She is someone that is so very special and dear to me. She also at times works with me also. And without further ado, we are going to let her introduce herself to you. And then we're going to come on back with some awesome words of life.
Good morning. Good morning, radio world. I like that, Sharon and Wayne. That's beautiful.
Thank you
all for allowing me to be in this space this morning.
Awesome.
And to experience this time of this point in my life.
Yes.
God is good. God is great.
Yes, he is.
And the amazing sunshine outside.
It is a beautiful day, isn't it?
It's a beautiful day. Miss Sharon asked me to come and just share a little bit about the passion that I have for the work that I do. She, I'm Wendy Truitt.
Yes, okay. Miss Truitt is in the house. She's excited, y'all, and passionate.
Yes, I'm Wendy Truitt. I'm a native Atlanta, and it's just, again, great
awesome.
To be here, to be alive,
yes.
to be well.
Yes, it is.
To be well and
yes.
have an uplifting spirit
yes.
to be able
yes.
to share with others.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
over the past 41 years, God has allowed me to be of service and help other people.
Wow.
And I think that's what Sharon wanted me to just kind of
yes,
talk about the passion.
Yes.
She said that I worked with families.
Yes.
Families who have a loved one with an addiction.
Mm.
And she asked me, why did I choose this field of work?
Exactly.
Why do I want to help people, help families?
Yes.
And I just simply would like to say, Sharon, I started because I had addiction in my family.
Wow.
And 41 years ago, we got help
and
things changed dramatically in my life.
That's amazing.
So I knew that if my family could change, other people, families could change. Because so many people don't talk about it.
That's right.
Especially back then.
That's
that
right.
That was in the early 80s.
Wow.
So fast forward, it's still, you'd be surprised here.
Walk on eggshells, huh?
People still don't like to address it and talk about it, but we have to talk about it. We have to talk about mental health, addiction, and the effects on loved ones, especially the children.
Wow.
You know, because the children are really the silent.
It's the ones that suffer.
Yeah, that suffer through silence because they don't know how to act or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so we got help. My family and I got help.
Wow.
And since then, that's what really gave me the passion to want to help others.
Yes.
So for the first couple of years, I just volunteered.
Wow.
Helping people.
Really?
And I just went
so you just volunteered?
Yes.
What?
Yes. Wow. I volunteered. And it became I say, oh, wow. It wasn't that I was seeking to do this, but it happened.
Wow, and that's amazing, Ms. Wendy. That's amazing. You know, that's kind of like when, you know, you step out because of something that you feel that you can solve a problem to. You step out in it because it reminds me of how I got started too, Ms. Wendy. It's amazing because when I got started, I volunteered as an assistant counselor. And that was the time that I found out my true calling.
Yes.
So you know what? That makes me to believe that that's what even more pushed you to what you are doing now.
Yes.
Because of stepping out and just giving up your time. And your service. Because, you know, in addiction, we talk about that. When you can do more when you give it away.
That's true.
I'm sorry to hold so topic, but you had me. Got me going.
That's good. Yeah. So, again, by me volunteering and then somebody at a facility seeing the work that I was doing with the people, and she offered me a job with no other experience than my own personal experience. So, that became a joy for me and a motivator for me. And in doing that, when the HIV pandemic hit in the early 80s, that motivated me to start going getting education and training and certifications to be able to adequately, you know, provide services in our communities. So since that, I just been on a, it's been a nonstop road. You know, it's a continuous journey. Mm-hmm. It's a continuous journey, being able to help people.
Wow.
And so that's what I haven't stopped since. You know, today I still work with I've been working with families and the clients who have substance abuse problems,
right.
And the impact that it has on families is overwhelming.
Wow.
Because they don't have the outlet
exactly
until they come and hear other people share, and then that give them the opportunity to open up about the pain that they've experienced living with a person who has the disease of addiction.
Yes, because not just only that person who has the addiction suffers, but the family
exactly
feels that pain.
Yes,
you know what I mean, Ms. Wendy.
Yes.
And because of that, you are so needed. You know, I am so thankful for you allowing yourself to step out. You know, because so many lives are being changed and set free. So many people are being set free. Not only that, but so many families know their problems and are being able to get help. To deal with it.
Yes.
From people like you.
Yes.
It's a blessing. It really is a blessing. You know, and so many things that I know that you have had to encounter to hear, to come in between, and to bring back together families. You know, it's amazing. You know, I want to ask you, in you helping people, you know, or families with this addiction struggle, have you ever encountered a mom or parents, I'll say a mom and a father, who just got frustrated and didn't know what to do?
Sure. A lot of families think that they caused it. They tried to control it.
Wow.
But I have to really educate them that it's not their fault. They didn't cause it.
Yes.
They can't control it. And they can't cure it.
Wow.
And families struggle with understanding that it is an addiction.
Yes.
They say, if that person loved me, they wouldn't do that.
Yes.
But they have to be educated that it is an illness.
It is.
You know, it's
is.
Just an illness, just like diabetes, heart disease, or any other type of disease. It has to be treated.
Wow.
And by that person being affected, the whole family system, the whole dynamics of the family is affected.
Yeah. And you know, Ms. Wendy, one thing, as me being a facilitator, that I hear that my clients that come in say, well, you know, my family's always saying, can't you just stop? Look like you can just stop. But Miss Wendy, you know, they talk about that, but, you know, it's hard because of the addiction. And that's where I know you come in, because you are able to tell the families about, it's not just about stopping. This has come about because of different things that have come up in their lives.
Sure.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Sure.
Can
sure.
you expand on that?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Yes. And that's why it's so important mm-hmm. to have a forum where families can come yes. together and receive and learn. Mm. See, a lot of families be in shock. Oh, it's a disease? Mm,
that's right. Because yeah. they never thought right. about it.
I
like
said,
that.
Yes, it's a fatal, mm-hmm. it's a chronic disease.
It is.
If
yes,
it's
it is.
Not a arrested,
yes.
if the client don't learn how to arrest their
Ooh,
disease.
Arrest it.
They will continue. And wow. the results are either jails, institutions, or death.
Wow.
And
wow.
the clients, we hope, our hope, or my hope,
yes,
is
our
that
hope.
The clients get treated and stay on the the journey of recovery.
That's right.
One day at a time.
One day at a time.
And
one
the
day.
Families have to learn that they need education yes. and help too.
Yes, yes.
So out in the communities today, there's many ways that families mm-hmm. and clients yes. can get help, ongoing help.
Wow.
It's places people can go, you know.
Yes.
So don't, a lot of times people try to isolate
is the
wrong
thing
to
do
by themselves,
yes.
but they cannot,
yes.
you know.
Yes.
They really need the help,
they need help.
Of others.
That's right.
And once they hear
yeah.
others share, mm-hmm. you know, just last week, exactly. Last Saturday at mm-hmm. this exact time.
Wow. Wow. That's right, Miss Wendy.
Last
yes,
week at this exact time, I had a big forum. I had
yes.
About 37 family members.
37?
In the setting.
Wow.
And also, after they received the education, I had a former client who he and his spouse
wow.
had did some individual work with me.
Wow.
And he stood up and shared his experience, strength,
awesome.
And hope.
Awesome.
And then the spouse,
wow.
she got up and shared her part on
wow.
her healing.
Wow.
And was saying how before he received help, she mm-hmm. didn't, she just thought he was crazy.
Wow.
But she did see some.
Yeah.
in him
okay.
that she didn't want to give up and walk away from the relationship.
Wow.
So now they are both in recovering
together. Oh,
yeah.
That's amazing.
She's learning
awesome.
You know how to
different
deal with family
issues and
mm-hmm.
stuff. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yes.
That's amazing. Wayne, what do you think about our special guest today? Miss Wendy.
Yes, ma'am, Mom. Yeah, that's amazing, Miss Wendy. You are doing your thing, and you got well qualified. And that goes to show that people out there, if you don't know, if you ain't got the right qualifications to save the world or dominate in your own way, you got it. Some will be out there and notice your work and notice the potential that you have for yourself and for everybody who knows you and for the lives you save around the world. So you, your families, everybody, your friends around you, Miss Wendy, you got it. You are definitely on it.
Thank you, Wayne.
Thank you so much. Radio World, we are going to come right back with Miss Wendy. Because later on, before we leave the show, Miss Wendy, I want you to tell them about different family groups in the community
mm-hmm.
is what we're going to talk about. Different groups of family groups in the community. We're going to have a break right now, and we want to give you this awesome song, and I hope you like it.
You are everybody, look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
I need you. You need me. You need me.
We're all apart.
We're all a part of God's body.
Stand with me.
Stand with me.
Look at somebody, tell them, agree with me.
Agree with
we're
me.
We're all a part.
We're all a part of God's body.
It is His will.
It is His will that every need be supplied. You are.
Yes, yes, yes. I need you. You need me. Yes, yes. We're all a part of God's body. We need each other. Yes. We need each other whole. We need each other being able to have change in our lives so that each one of us can be better. And we are so thankful to have Miss Wendy in here today because she's changing lives. She's allowing families to come back together and understand this disease called addiction, but most of all, to put it to rest. As she said, rest out, arrest it, and know how to deal with it to make life better for those that are involved, those that want to see this thing ceased and over with. Miss Wendy, just wanted you to give some more comments to us about what you do and the difference that you make in the lives of so many.
Yes, thank you, Sharon. You know, it's, again, I mentioned it earlier, but it's important to talk about these issues.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
I can remember when I first started doing this work, some of my mother's friends, my mother was so happy of the changes that our family had made.
Wow.
Some of her friends would whisper to her, someone. I said, Mama, make them talk up loud. You know, because that's what has kept people sick, the silence.
That's right, silence.
So supporting a loved one dealing with mental health or substance use disorder, what do? You start the conversation. How can you help start that conversation? You can identify the appropriate time and place to bring up the issue, to start to consider, you know, the timing of everything. Right. Then express your concerns and be direct. You know, you're doing this, and this. Yes. You know, something is going on. You know, a lot of times people, again, just think it's going to pass.
Right.
And it's not. It's going to progress and get worse.
It's not.
So you acknowledge their feelings and listen to them. Because a lot of times people try to wiggle their way out of it. But that's why it's so important for you to be direct.
Right.
Be able to say, this and this is happening.
Put it all on the table.
And then offer help. Today, it's many places that people can get help with this illness. And then just be patient. Because it is a relapsable disease. Sometimes people relapse and don't get it the first time. But if grace give them the ability to stay alive, they can have another opportunity. And some people, and many stories that I heard, stories of struggles, triumph, and resilience. I've heard people say the first time, or the second time, or the third time, or the fourth time, but this time I got it.
Yes.
But people always have to remember, some people don't get that many chances.
That's right. That's
because
right.
It's sad to That's say, right. mm-hmm. as well as we have success stories, there's a lot of sad stories, too. Because a few months back, a family that I was working with, I had just met the guy that sat that Friday, and his family came that Saturday for family, to get family education.
Wow.
And they were so hopeful when they left. They said, we learned a lot. They were so hopeful. So a lot of times I'll follow up with the families. And when I called a week later to follow up, they say, oh, you didn't hear? I said, no. Say he left, drank again, and fell on the curb and hit his head and died.
Ooh.
I guess that's how, you know, that's from their report. They weren't absolutely sure, but they believe that's what happened. So it's sad stories, too, you know, and a lot of the substances that are out there today that people are using is really killing a lot of our people. You know, so we have to be able to talk about it and try to offer people the help, the resources to go and get help. And if anybody listening who knows somebody, I can give you a number that you could call to just get started. It's like a Georgia line that a
crisis line
that'll help you in the right direction. And that number is 1-800-715-4225. That's 1-800-715-4225. And that's just a place to start. They'll give you in the direction for whatever your needs are. And just again, ask for help. I'm quite sure it's people in your community, you know, even some churches may know because we have to educate the clergy members because everybody have different routes of getting help. So there's many places in our communities that provides help and services.
Yes, come out of the silence and let it be known to get set free and to be able to live your full life, your best life. It is possible. That's why we have her here today, so we can get the help we need, because it's okay if you need help. Get it and get set free. We're going to take another break right now, and then we're going to come back and we're going to talk to Miss Wendy and ask her another question.
Thank you.
When you can't turn to anyone around you, don't forget to look up.
I know it seems like the rain just won't end. Let me reassure you that it will.
Try to be strong.
Try to be strong and keep it all in.
Inside
you wish someone knew what you feel.
Let me remind you. Yeah.
We have a friend.
He's the best friend.
In Jesus.
Yeah.
And when we need him.
Just when we need him.
We lift our hands and say, we need your help.
You are our help.
You are our help.
And we believe.
Ask for help. And let me share something with you, radio world. God may not come down himself and give you the help you need, but he uses people. Be open. Be open for change. Be open to get you some help from those who are educated and knowledgeable to give you direction in a new way, so that you can live a full life, your best life, like I said before, to live a life that you wanted, always wanted to walk in. And that's what Miss Wendy is doing. She is allowing herself to be utilized by what we call a higher power, which is our God, to get the help that you need. It is okay. And continue to search out the help. As she gave you the phone number to the crisis information, please get your help. We will leave that number also at the radio station. If there's anyone that needs to get help, we can't say that enough, because it's our passion to get you the help that you need. Wayne, what you think about that? Getting help to make your life better.
Oh, yeah, of course, Mom. That is just amazing. You got to get help. It's important to, because, you know, with mental health and everything that's going with you physically and mentally and just emotionally, you got to ask for help. You can't go through it alone, because you'll just go crazy and berserk and don't want, and that devil comes in. He just controls your mind and fill you with things in your head with want to harm yourself, want to even, God forbid, kill yourself. So you got to say those thoughts. Say how you feel. Say how you speak. Speak how you feel. Got to get help and also say what you want out of life.
And you know, a lot of times people use drugs and alcohol to get away from their issues and their problems. And that's one thing we want you to get away from, because that problem is still going to be right there. And that's why we are allowing information and people who are dedicated and have the passion like Miss Wendy to get you where you need to be. It's up to you to stay there, because you can do it. So many others have. And we're depending on you to do it for yourself. Miss Wendy, we want you to take this time out and, you know, whatever, any words you have for the radio world.
Yes. And again, Sharon said that beautifully about the person who may have the addiction. But again, going back to the family, most families who have a loved one with an addiction enable. So I just want to touch bases on enabling.
Mm.
You know, some families avoid the problem. They deny that there is a problem, knowing that it's a problem.
They deny.
And start feeling resentful, but not talking about it. Feeling resentful or doing it in an unhealthy way. Ignoring or tolerating the individual's problematic behavior.
Just tolerating it.
Mm-hmm. Making excuses or covering up.
Yes.
For their behavior.
Yes.
So that they don't have to face the consequences which they need to face.
Yes.
And providing financial assistance that help them maintain that problematic behavior.
Yes.
And sacrificing or neglecting their own needs.
Yes.
Taking over the responsibilities that person should be doing, but they're taking over.
Wow.
So enabling is a big part of what families contribute and help that person to stay sick longer or even to sabotage their chance to get help.
Wow.
So it's important that families learn that.
That's good.
And I'm just so grateful that God has allowed me to stay on the battlefield. Mm-hmm. I call it a daily battlefield.
Wow, that's good.
With a clean and sane mind.
Yes.
To be able to help other people.
It's amazing, Ms. Wendy.
And in doing that, I think you asked me one of the questions earlier about self-care.
Yeah, I was going to ask you that. Yes, ma'am. How do you treat yourself when it comes to self-care?
Yes. And doing this work, it can be overwhelming. So some of the things I do is I listen to music.
Mm-hmm.
And since the pandemic, I color a lot.
Wow.
I love adult coloring books. And I even created one back during the pandemic.
Awesome.
And music and nature.
Gotcha.
I love the ocean and I love nature.
Awesome.
And I think we're kind of short of time, but I just, you know, just do the things to stay uplifted so I can uplift other people.
What a message. Miss Wendy, we thank you so much for coming in today. You have really and truly blessed not just us, but so many people that have heard your voice today. And you know what? At any time, you are so welcome to come back, because this is a deadly disease that we are going to be determined to take it out.
That's true.
For so many lives. And this is also life speaking. Taking away the darkness and bringing a light onto this thing that we got to get rid of. We thank you so much for joining us. And please come again on next Saturday, where we will be speaking life the way that God gives it to us. Have a wonderful day. We love you and we thank you for joining us.
Yes, we do. Thank you.
Bye-bye now.
All right. Yeah.